It's almost hard to believe we're only about a mile from the town of Friday Harbor. Welcome to Tern Island and your Washington State Marine Parks.
Being so close to the largest town in the San Juan Islands and on a busy ferry route, this lovely little island still makes for a nice getaway. There are some great beaches for landing dinghies and kayaks, and a wonderful walking trail wraps around the island too.
Tern Island is located at the north end of Griffin Bay, just off the northeast corner of San Juan Island.
If you're approaching from the south via Cattle Pass, don't be in too much of a hurry and take the channel at the south end of Tern Island. Though navigable, armed with local knowledge, it is a reef and rock-strewn pass. The recommended approach is from the west. Give the marker at Tern Rock plenty of room. In addition to the rock, there is an ever-present kelp field. You can pass inside the marker favoring the Tern Island shore, but beware of strong tide rips. This angle doesn't even begin to show how strong they can be. That sailboat is sensibly going around the marker.
Even the west approach has currents to contend with, as you can see from this time-lapse sequence. However, the state park mooring buoys are placed closer to shore and inside the current. There is plenty of room to anchor seaward of the buoys, but that will put you in the current. Others have opted to try anchoring in the pass between islands.
Our cruising guide indicated boats that have anchored in the pass off the southwest tip of Tern Island have experienced some pretty strong currents.
But boats that have anchored farther out and closer to the eastern mouth of the pass had less current to deal with.
We opted for one of the park buoys. Once secured, we eyed the more protected southwest beach for a dinghy landing. And though we were out of the current, you can see that the swell from passing ferries and boats can make this a somewhat rolly spot during the high season. Because it's so well protected from passing swells, this is the beach most people use as a landing. It's a nice open spot and a great place to have a picnic, with restrooms located nearby. The other beach on the island's west side offers more shade, with a denser forest of tall trees. This is also where you'll find the island's only pay station.
Remember, pack it in and pack it out, especially here in the islands.
There's a very short walk from the southwest beach to another one on the southeast side. From here, you can see just some of the hazardous rocks at the entrance to the southern pass. There are a couple of picnic tables with nice views to Lopez Island. The trail around the island isn't too difficult and even provides views of Mount Baker on clearer days. From the trail, views to the north and especially to the west are pretty good too. And being so close to the town of Friday Harbor, which is the largest and busiest port in the islands, the scenery at Tern Island is always changing.
For more information on Tern Island State Park, visit the Washington State Parks website at parks.wa.gov.